Welcome to Irvine, California, site of the Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX. I'm Scott Brighthop, your host, with co-host Lenny Baticki. We're out here to show you the hottest competition in bicycle motocross and the world's richest purse, $30,000. Lenny, what pros are out here for the mega money run?
Scott, virtually every pro in BMX is here at the Vision Streetwear World Cup. Harry Larry, pro points leader Pete Lunkarevich, they're all here. Greg Hill, you know, they've even got some pros coming out of retirement. Malin Abrams, Bubba Hayes, and the Malachis. The Patterson brothers are here coming out of retirement. Who knows where they're coming back from? Everyone's here at this race.
All the hot and heavy pros in bicycle motocross. And what amateur classes are we going to cover today, Lenny?
Scott, we're going to take a look at the little guys, the 7-year-old experts, the awesome 17 experts. We'll be looking at pro cruisers and both A and B pro classes.
Well, there you have it. Lots of exciting competition coming from the Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX, and we'll be back to show you all the action. Before we get to the semis, let's take a look at some training tips with top 15 expert Brian Lopes on exercises and stretching.
Training is a big part of BMX racing. When you're just sitting at home, maybe you have nothing to do or something, you should train for your racing. Get on your bike, go out to the street, maybe sprint like 75 yards or so. Whatever it takes to get you tired. If you don't like doing it by yourself, get a buddy and just sprint down the street as hard as you can. Also, you can go to the nearest jumping place, go jumping around for a couple hours. Practice your speed jump, double jumps, whatever it takes. Also, you can go to the gym, lift weights, do curls with your arms, maybe do a few squats all the way down. Whatever it takes to build up your muscles so you can be in top physical fitness. Once you get out to the track, I always like to do a few stretches before actually riding. I like to do some toe touches, you know, stretch out the back of your legs, do some waist things to loosen your back, maybe pull your arms like this and stretch out your triceps, relax your neck, roll it around, get all the tension out, do some shoulder shrugs, loosen up your shoulders. All this is good, you know, just for mental concentration, and also when you crash, you don't want to be all stiff, so you just, you know, hit the ground. You want to be able to roll so you don't get hurt.
Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX is unique in that it's open to all classes of competition except for beginners, making for an incredible 54 amateur main events and 5 pro classifications. Over 300 motos or individual heats in all. From this, we're going to concentrate on 12 of the hottest classifications, starting off with the highly aggressive 13-year-old experts. Expert. 13 experts, semi-main, number one, Chris Sanchez, Green, Severs, Palmese, Markley, Stamatz, Winter, and Henderson.
Henderson taken.
Oh, Henderson goes down. Down. 1, 2, 3, pile on top of him. It's Chicken George Severs out in front with Justin
Green looking good in second to CW Ryder. Severs now pouring it on down the third
Palmese
straightaway.
Palmese pulling into third spot. And number 37 up there is Sean Winters. He's on the bubble in that fourth spot with number 67, Andy Markley, breathing right down his neck, Lenny.
Severs and Green coming in for the win here. The battle for fourth looked like the quick line rider from San Diego take.
It's going to be Palmese.
Watch this race here. Next moto down, Gonzalez on the inside, Romero, but out in front, the world champion riding for Murray. An hour later, Shelby James. James all over the bike. He's got Romero behind him, and Gonzalez gunning it into the turn. Shelby out in front, world champion, national number one, the guy you can't say enough about, one of the nicest guys in BMX.
Behind Romero comes John Gonzalez, and look at our Hawaiian print shirt boy, number 37, out there in that fourth spot. He's going to qualify. That's Michael Thomas for the 13 Expert Semi.
Thomas, I look like he's a Team Louie Louie there in fourth. Shelby James taking the win in that round.
Everybody looking strong as they come down the track. Spurrier with a good first pedal, but here comes Robert Swick and Willie Nelson. Swick taking the lead, the GT rider from California. Nelson into the inside, the Arizona color control rider powers out of the turn. It's Nelson in front, Robert Swick behind him, and there's Bernard Gant with Spurrier back there, the Tennessee local. As they come out of the turn, Willie Nelson still pedaling strong. Nelson up and down the backside of the jump. He's got Swick right on the tail there, and Gant in third. It's Gant riding for Eagle Snack. Swick, GT, and out in front, color control rider going to take it home. It's going to be Nelson in for the lead in the transfer spot. Swick behind him. There's Spurrier and Gant, third and fourth. Gant is down on the next one already. More 15-year-old semi-action. Parnell Haley from Corpus Christi, Texas, on the outside, and Lopes goes and takes it away from him. It's Brian Lopes, the SE rider from California now, in front. Lopes, Haley, Chad Hatfield from Atlanta, Georgia, slips up into the third spot, and there's Lincourt with Lyons kind of trying to get in there for the fourth spot. Brian Lopes out in front, down the backside of the jump. It's still Lopes into the back turn. Brian Lopes, the flying Brian from SE Racing, out in front, looks to the finish line. It's going to be Lopes, Parnell Haley going to come in for second. Chan Hatfield from Georgia, the Robinson rider, and looks like Lyons finishing fourth.
These kids are the exciting future of the sport, but let's go back for a moment and take a look at the pioneering efforts of an earlier BMX generation.
Let's take a look at the major developments in the sport of bicycle motocross over the past 17 years. Way back in November of 1970, a motorcycle rider trailing around in a vacant field noticed kids imitating him. So he organized an event, then started weekly bicycle motocross competitions. The first real BMX-type bicycle, Yamaha Motor Corporation, fully shocked bicycle, introduced to give the kids the feel of daddy's motorcycle with front and rear shocks. Then came the Mongoose, the all-durable bicycle designed by a wheel manufacturer, Skip Hess. First came the Motomag, then the mass-market Mongoose. A strong steel bicycle, great for the rigors of bicycle motocross. Then came in 1976, our uniform. The real fun stuff, the glory and the good looks, the heroes developed out of this stage. We have padded pants, padded jerseys, nylon vented, motorcycle-style helmets. Bicycle motocross got its own identity in this time period. And then, of course, the old guys, the guys that felt that, hey, they were a little bit too big for these little child bikes, came the cruiser. Basically developed from the old-style beach cruiser, but this one is a high-tech, all-chrome ollie with aluminum accessories, a very lightweight but yet strong and durable bike. As the old-timers decided that they wanted to stay involved and wanted to make themselves more efficient on the track, they developed a 24-inch bike. This one, again, all aluminum and chrome ollie combinations. Very lightweight, very strong. It kept the older guys in. So now bicycle motocross has developed into 5-year-olds all the way up to 41 and over cruiser classes. So it is a sport of all ages. And finally, the bike of today, super strong, super light, basically kid-proof. And here we have 17 years of development into the sport of bicycle motocross. Definitely not a fad. In fact, the sport of the 80s. We're here with Alex Baum of the United States Cycling Federation with some encouraging news for the sport of bicycle motocross. Alex, can you tell us the current developments about bicycle motocross and the possibilities of the Olympics?
Well, there is not anymore if there's a possibility, it's when there's a possibility. First of all, since the International Cycling Federation adopted BMX as one of their sports, now it's becoming naturally very clear that it will be in the Olympics in the next 2 or 3 years.
Scott, let's go back to the track.
Yep, and there's history in the making right here, because we've got the world's largest ever $30,000 pro purse at the Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX.
Sounds great.
Time now for the real rippers of bicycle motocross, the Mighty Mites, the 7-Expert main event.
7-Expert main event stacked full of big names. Thunstrom, Anderson, LaCastro, Von Troth, Branzell, Dugan, Cooper, and Coburn.
Absolutely, and it's real surprising how a 7-Expert can do some of the jumps and the riding talent that they have. It's amazing. Some talented little pocket rockets.
They're out of the gate, and here comes the 7-year-old Expert main event. Down the track they go, the Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX. All the riders up and over the jump. We've got a crash. Lots of guys going down all over the first jump. Out in front now, Brian Cooper, the Elf rider, moves into the lead. Behind him, Golden Anderson, SE Racing. It's Cooper now in front over the whoop-de-doos. Brian Cooper riding strong up and down the jumps. He goes Cooper with Anderson in the pursuit team as they come around the track. Anderson there, Sundstrom getting up, picking up the pieces. David Colburn in third over the jumps in the third straightaway. Cooper still holding off Anderson. Brian Cooper, three wins in the motos today, looking to get a perfect here as he comes down the back straightaway. Elf rider Brian Cooper still in the lead. Anderson right there with him. It's going to be Cooper and Anderson. Anderson, the silver medal today. Brian Cooper taking the win.
Training tip number two has Brian Loeb showing us his recommendations of the proper safety equipment for BMX racing.
Okay, safety equipment is probably the most important thing you need. A helmet is definitely the most important. You're going to end up on your head one of the times when you crash and want to protect your head as much as possible. A mouth guard is also important. You know, you crash, you don't want to fall on your chin and scrape it up or anything. Next, you probably need some good gloves. Leather gloves are probably good, but you can wear garden gloves or anything. So when you fall, you usually put your hands off first and you don't want to scrape your hands all up. Next, you have to wear a long sleeve shirt. And one with little thin elbow pads is pretty good too. They just protect, you know, get little scrapes and stuff on your elbow. Also, you could wear strap-on elbow pads. Those are even better. They have more padding and protection in them. Next, you want to wear long pants, or leathers are better. Leathers have hip pads in them, and they also have knee pads in the knee. So when you fall, you don't, you know, scrape up your knees and stuff, the rocks go. And pants are good too. If you're gonna wear pants, wear jeans because they're more protective than sweat. Also, try to get a shoe with a nice flat bottom. And no, running shoes are okay, but you know, a flat bottom shoe is usually better. Stays flatter on your flat pedal and stuff. It's also important that you keep your bike well maintained. In racing, you gotta have some kind of grip that covers the end of your handlebar, so if you crash or something, the end of your handlebar, the sharpened side, doesn't hurt anyone when you crash. You also need to have your safety pad. If you fall on your bar, you know, you don't want to land on metal and everything, so you got some padding in there. Also, you want to make sure that your seat's tight. If you crash or anything, and you go to sit down on your seat, and it's pointing straight up, you know, that won't feel too well. Also, you need to make sure that your chain is not too tight and not too loose. You want your cranks and everything to spin freely, but you also don't want it, you know, too loose so it's going to fall off when you're pedaling quick. Also, you should make sure that your axles and your pedals are tight. You know, you don't want going over a jump and your front wheel come off in midair or something. Now you'll be ready to race BMX.
Coming up on the line now, Scott, is a 17-year-old expert main event. Up there is Mike Kenioklis, the world-class rider from Ohio, Craig Biddos, Mike King, the Haro rider from San Diego, James Dean, new Los Angeles resident, riding for Hardee's Foods Corporation, Desert Dave Cullinan from up there in the middle of the state of California, the world champion, now riding for CW, Eric Carter, Lonnie Learley's there, Dave Gaddis, the big brother is a BMX, a 17-year-old expert, the whole family here to watch him, ready to go, the little guys in the crowd, the moms, the dads, all of them cheering on the big guy in the family, the 17-year-old expert semi, ready to come down. The gate is off, and here we go. Down the track, it's Carter on the outside, Mike Kenioklis to the inside. Kenioklis and Carter going up and down. James Dean moves into third as they round the first turn. It's Kenioklis up and down the whoop-de-doos. Carter, though, right there beside him. Watch the world champion looking strong. It's still Kenioklis in front. Mikey King, the Haro Riders, moved into third. Cullinan trying to get into fourth. It's Carter now out into the lead. He goes around Kenioklis into the back turn. It's CW USA Airs, Eric Carter in front. Towards the home stretch he goes. It's going to be Carter, Kenioklis, Mikey King, the Haro rider, coming in for third.
The fourth next race, the other 17 expert semi, Mitchell, Hayden, Milwee, Mackey, Tatton, Pavlovsky, and Kaminsky.
I see Pavlovsky, Tatton, Milwee, and Mitchell and Hayden all battling tough in that first turn.
It is going to be a hard one. You know, these are some of the top guys, future pros for sure in this group. Most of these riders have been at the sport almost 5 years. Gate down on this one. Look at Danny Milwee in the middle of it.
Danny Milwee, whole shots Hayden on the inside, though. Couldn't be making a move. Oh, Hayden
goes off his seat, lands in the top bar, but he's recovered, but he's all the way back to seventh.
SE rider Danny Nelly in front of the Elf rider Glenn Pavlovsky. Both these riders having a lot of input. Pavlovsky, the major factor in designing this track. Millwee, Pavlovsky, Tatton, and Billy Al, another Ohio rider into
here
the
here comes
spot.
Mitchell trying to make a move on Billy Al. It's not going to work, though. Matt Hayden is not going to qualify in this, one of the toughest qualifiers, the semi-main and the 17 expert at the Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX.
Millwee and Pavlovsky both in tremendous run, 18-year-old experts. We'll talk about him. It's Todd Corbett, Mr. Zellwood in front. Corbett is your leader. Darwin Griffin, Jameson Handler, and Foreman. TC Todd Corbett, part of the E team, in front from Zellwood. Oh, he gets sketchy over to the jump.
Mr. Murray Corbett squaring off that turn, losing his momentum, but they don't seem to be pulling him much down that straightaway, Lenny.
Murray getting a lot of support from the Nauer leader people recently. In and through the turn, he's got Handler behind him. Whoa, as they go down the back straightaway, it's going to be Corbett. Mr. Zellwood.
There's a move going up there for fourth.
Whoa, it looks like Foreman and one of the crit plate Eastern riders battling right in there. Next gate will be more 18-year-old efforts. Sweet, Wimberly, Polajewski, Walker, Linder, Tenet, Johnson, Donnell. More hot racing. Look at Jeff Donnell.
Look at Jeff Donnell and Terry Tenet wheeling down that straightaway, looking like he has a motor on that bike.
The start of a life for Donnell, and Tenet takes it away from him, though, coming out of the first turn. Terry Tenet, GT Minute in front. Jeff Donnell still hanging out there. As they go around the turn, Cecil Johns.
Oh, he's off his pedals, but back on him again. There's some foot scrambling going on out there.
Ronnie Walker moving into the fourth place. Tommy Kolajewski, the fifth spot. He's got a bent seat post trying to hang on. He must have had that in the crash. Tenet and Donnell with Johns Walker. It's goodbye, Kolajewski.
Chicken wings Walker makes it on the bubble in that fourth spot.
Although it should be easy to find enough action out here on the track, some riders will actually look beyond BMX to reach their daily adrenaline quota. Earlier, we talked with one such top pro, Tommy Bracken.
Tell me, Tommy, we know you're in some other activities. Tell us about your other bicycle events.
Well, I'm in a GPV besides BMX.
Can you describe GPV for me?
GPV is a gravity-powered vehicle. That means you coast downhill with no cranks, no pedals, no nothing to drive the rear wheel but gravity.
And how fast is Tommy Brackens going on a GPV bike?
85 plus.
Woo! We're talking major speed. You thought BMX was fast? This crazy man goes downhill at 85. I know we just had an event down in Palm Springs a few weeks back, and what did you think of the course? How'd you finish?
Well, the course is extremely fast. It's a little bit bumpy, but it was extremely fast, extremely fair for all the riders, and I was hoping to race against you in the main.
Well, unfortunately, I didn't make the main. I have a few little burns here to prove why. Unfortunately, we had a blown tire, and I did go down, but still enjoyed the ride. Being current national champ at GPV, what are your aspirations for the next year to finish off 87?
For GPV, I'm just going to stay with it and just give it the best shot I possibly can.
I understand you're on the new board of directors of the GPV Association.
Yes, I am. I'm glad to be a part of that association.
What will be, what is your duties as a board member on the GPV?
Well, just to make sure that the rules lays out for everybody. Everybody has the fair and straight line of the GPV and make sure they have a clean, constant clean race.
Will there be classifications in the new organization?
Yes, there will be. We're going to eliminate the weight class. You know, that's the most important part is the weight. We don't want anybody getting hurt in this sport if we can help it.
Gee, Lenny, look up there. We got the Mighty Might Midgets of Bicycle Motocross, the five novice main event. Who's in it?
Joshua, Sean, Justin, Ryan, Jason, Kyle, Sonny, and Wayne. I won't even give you their last names yet. They can't spell them yet. They're on a first name basis.
These are little rippers, the Mighty Mites of BMX, the five-year-old novice, jumping for it over the big set of doubles.
Into turn number one, these little guys going at it. That's looks like Justin Grice in front. Oh, Grice getting swooped now. Grice back to second as they charge into that second turn.
Coming little into the bull turn, look at those cute little legs rocking and rolling. Trying to pedal that bike down the straightaway.
The Mighty Mites out there, it's Kyle Lee Bentley, but look at Justin Grice.
Justin's brake checking him, coming into the corners. Justin's saying, come on, buddy, I'm ready to rock and roll.
Bentley, your lead rider, the 530 down the back straightaway. These little guys, it's the Pee Wee Herman class in front. Bentley's got it. It's going to be
rider goes off
Bentley.
The track here.
Bentley taking it. Grice, the second. A good race in the five novices. Pleasure to watch those little guys.
Cute little guys.
From the Mighty Mites to the mighty man who made this event possible, Brad Dorfman of Vision Streetwear. Brad, what interests you about bicycle motocross, and why would you be so heavily involved?
Well, Scott, as you know, we manufacture a line of clothing called Vision Streetwear, which is a line of tennis shoes and active sportswear. And BMX is just a really fun, active sport that we're really proud to be part of. The youth market is a real exciting energy, high energy market, and our clothing is, I feel, is the same, very exciting and high energy.
Tell me, I understand you're involved in some other youth sports activities and products. Can you tell me about those?
Right. We also sponsor riders in skateboarding, snowboarding, freestyle bicycles, anything that's youth-oriented, we're involved in. I think BMX is very exciting. I saw a little kid about 3 years old going around the track that I just couldn't believe, and I'm really happy to be part of it, and I'm looking forward to more of it.
Fantastic. Get ready for training tip number 3 with Brian Lopes. This time he's going to teach you how to get the snap out of the starting gate.
Okay, well, the first thing you usually look for when you get onto a gate is make sure that the surface that you're starting on has no dirt on it. Because if there's some dirt on it, you allow your back wheel to spin, and that could lose the race right there for you getting a bad gate start like that. Next, you usually move down to balancing. When you balance, usually you put your front wheel, try to get as straight as possible on the gate, have your pedals set so you can keep a lot of pressure on the gate. A lot of pressure will help you balance easier. If you don't have a lot of pressure on it, just allow your front wheel to slip and you can just fall a lot easier. Next thing you want to do is just try to concentrate on the gate. You need a lot of concentration when you get on the gate. You can't let other people around you, voices disturb you, because concentration is probably 80% of your mental preparation. And the gate start is one of the most important. In practice, you gotta keep looking at the lights and see when they're going down, when the gate starter's, his words might help you. When the starter says, set them up, usually that's when you wanna stand up on your pedals, keep pressure against the gate. And when he says, rider's ready, you should start leaning back and put a lot of pressure on the pedals. When he says, watch the light, you should start moving forward and try to get the best start as you can on the green.
Set them up. Rider's ready. Watch the light. Pro Cruiser Semi coming up. Griffin, Leach, Root, Chipres, Patterson, Matten, Lankarevich, and Slavic. All of the hot pros in a Pro Cruiser Semi. This will be the first of two. The top four go on to the Pro Cruiser Money Main Event. Wow, it looks like Dana Griffin, you know, you got to watch him, but I'm looking at Brian Patterson, out of retirement. You know, he tripled at a World Cup once.
I'm going to have to go with Eric Roop on this one. Eric is leading Pro Cruiser points, I believe. Pete Lankarevich is on a borrowed bicycle. Money's been dollar signs are in his eyes, and he says, I'm going to come out and whoop the Cruisers too. Okay, Pro Cruiser number one on the line, as we said. Griffin, Leach, Root, Chippers, Patterson, Madden, Lankarevich, and Slavic, and the gate's down.
The gate's down. Bill Madden causing all kinds of havoc on the inside. Jimmy Leach now, the pro out of the northeast. CNH colors in front. Patterson now on it with Root. It's Leach, Root, Patterson, your top three. Madden,
Root making
Slavic
a move for the lead. He is a powerhouse on a cruiser, a phenomenally talented rider, a family man with children, lovely wife, living down in Chula Vista, California.
Daddy, Eric Root, Anamagas in front. He's got Leach, Patterson. Look at Slavic.
Slavic
going past
making
Griffin
a move. Look at Pete making a move. Pete blows his pedal, says, forget it. You guys go ahead, qualify for the big buck. Pro Cruiser purse at the Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX.
Looking good. Next Pro Cruiser race, Palmer, Hull, Justice, Roth, Henderson, Balch, Henry in Texas. Another hot group of the big boys on
this
big
bikes.
This
could be a main event at any national.
They're looking ready. Down the track they go. Problems for Roth already on the inside. There's Texas and Kevin Sheepdog Hull now in front. The former Austin, Texas local now living in Garden Grove.
Darnell Henry, the red line rider out there in the second spot. And Richard Roth trying to make a move. Bulch, and here comes Sean Texas.
Texas takes him off the turn. That's Kevin Hull in front, Texas now. There's Jared Justice moving up into the fourth, but Palmer's got sights on that one. Hull, Palmer bouncing in there, taking it away from Justice. Kevin in front of Sean.
It's a battle to the finish. Palmer's moving over on Justice, giving him no room except for the fence.
Wow, Dennis Boss qualifying in third, and Rick Palmer hard charging, rocking right
what
into the finish line.
A set of semis.
Eric Group, winner of the Pro Cruiser semi number one, looks like the man to beat on this track. Of course, as his wife and kids might tell you, Mr. Roop is a winner off the track, too.
Having a husband who is a professional BMX racer is very fun and exciting. He travels all over the country and all over the world, for that matter, and I have gone with him several times. But when he does have a few days off, it's very much quality time with myself and the children. And I'm very happy that he is setting such a good example for other kids in the BMX sport, because he is such a good person and a good father and a very good person to look up to.
Being a husband and a parent, I get some pretty interesting responses from people when I tell them what my occupation is. A lot of times they don't understand, and they say, well, you race bicycles, but what do you do for a living? And I said, well, I travel around the country and I race week in and week out, and that's what I do for a living. And they say, on those little bikes you do that? I see the future of BMX really, really shining brighter in the next few years, because we have so many new sponsors coming in, like Vision Streetwear and Eagle Snacks and Mongoose Bicycles, getting involved in sponsoring these races and promoting the sport of BMX. It's only going to help. That brings in the television coverage. More people get to see it. It's just going to become bigger and bigger. This particular race here at Irvine, the World Cup, is got such a big purse that the pressure's really on. My strategy is just going to be to transfer through the motos and through the semis. And when I get on that line for that main event, I'm going to be going for broke. It's going to be first or nothing, because it's a big money race and the recognition is all in getting first place. And I really, that's what I've set my goal on, is to win this race.
We'll be seeing more of Mongoose's Eric Group in the Pro Cruiser main. But right now, let's go to the 13 Expert main, which is on the gate.
And it's quite a main event we have here. Scott coming down the starting hill. It looks like they're all even, but whoa, Shelby James, the Murray Annihilator rider, is taking the lead. It's James out in front, the big number one, world champion, national champion, pedaling out of the turn. He's got Seavers behind him, Chicken George Seavers riding the GT colors. James, Seavers, Justin Green somewhere, and look at Green taking it away from Seavers. Green now in the second spot, but whoa, Shelby James down the third straightaway. James has got himself a new area code between him and Justin Green. And as they round to the turn, it looks like Shelby James is going to be your Vision Streetwear World Cup winner here. Johnny the Heat Gonzalez going to take second. Justin Green third. The battle for fourth, too close. We'll leave it to the scores.
A pro class on the line. Who do we got in this one?
Abrams, Balch, Blazer, Ellis, Pete Lunkarevich, and Charlie Townsend. This is going to be hot. Six riders going after four positions for the biggest pro purse ever in BMX history.
Well, you know, I saw Malin Abrams. I thought he broke a pedal shaft in one of his qualifying heats. They slipped him in here.
Looks like he's got back on it. Ellis on the inside, Lunkarevich outside into the first turn. The Lumberjack not able to do it. It's Pistol Pete, the Haro Pro, over the triples.
He holds his line easy, and Lumberjack couldn't push him out of the way. It's Blazer trying to make a move, and Malin trying to block the track and keep back.
I've got my eye on Townsend in fifth spot, trying to get around Abrams. Big Charlie Townsend, freight train. He's got the back straightaway. I don't know whether it's going to happen. Lunkarevich, Ellis, Blazer. There's Abrams. Watch Townsend as they come
along. Look at Townsend motor that bicycle.
Lunkarevich,
powerhouse.
Blazer and Ellis are in fourth spot. It's gonna
be anxious to see the results of that one.
Oh,
could
man.
Could it be Townsend or could it be Abrams? Round number two on the line, we got Larry, Jika, Langthorne, Henry Chanaday, and powerhouse Greg Hill, the most consistent rider, winning all of his motos yesterday in the SC Nationals and the main event. And today, I haven't seen him lose a race yet.
Hill and Lunkarevich have yet to race today. It's going to be a main event for them if Greg can get in this. Gate is
He's
down.
Got a good Chanaday. Start. Chanaday. Turnell Henry on the inside, and powerhouse Greg Hill is out there in the lead for Robinson Racing again.
Look at Nelson right on Greg's back tire. We lose two of them. That leaves four up. Greg Lambthorne in the fourth spot. That's the pro that drove out here and slept in his vehicle once or twice.
I love it. The underdog's in there. By chance, fate of God, he's in.
Look
the
at the
main event.
Greg Hill, Nelson, the interceptor, Chanaday, Turnell Henry, and Greg Lambthorne, the final four in the Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX Pro Class $30,000 Pro Purse.
Simply amazing. Talk about hot racing. Of course, the question beckons. How do these guys cool off? They get wet, of course.
SC Racing. We make it happen.
B-Pro running for $7,000 here today. Hildreth, Straney, Miranda, Moore, Clymer, Justice, LeBaron, and Newberry. I'm going with David Clymer, my redhead.
Oh, man, he's on the outside gate. If he's been talking to rocks, wonder if his spaceship is fired up. We'll have to find out. Dave Clymer, the pressure on from the outside gate.
LeBaron on the very inside says, told me between these heats that he was getting tight, but his start was bad.
It's Moore, Justice, and Clymer on the outside. Mike Moore, the Dallas Pro, in front. J.J. Jarrett, Justice. Looks like Clymer's having trouble in the middle of the pack now. Moore and Justice with Newberry and Hildreth now on it. Back in the fifth spot is our guy, Dave Clymer, and he's having a tough time of it. Maybe work his way back around Hildreth. Up and over the jump, it looks like Moore back in the pack. Dave Clymer still working for the fourth spot. Sean Hildreth side by side.
Clymer got into that fourth spot. Look at him pull down that final straightaway over the last jump. They're battling for that fourth spot.
Oh, Woo! Yeah.
Three-way tie in there for fourth. I'm sure Clymer got in. Who was the other rider?
Justice and Moore were the first two. Clymer in for third. The fourth spot could have gone to Hildreth or Newberry.
B-Pro semi number two.
Jay, Siebert, Griffin, Davis, Lofgren, Hayes, Adelot, and Johnson. Eight more rough and tumble B-Pros on the gate. You know, Bubba Hayes is just coming back off retirement. Doug Davis is the top former amateur.
He's been out playing baseball in school, and he's back looking strong as ever. Out of the gate, out of the center of the pack, it's Bubba Hayes, and on the outside.
Look at Adelot.
Look at that tight battle.
Kevin Adelot, the color control pro, in front. He's got Davis and Hayes with Griffin behind him. Kevin Adelot now jamming into the second turn. Color control, we talked about it before, a family-oriented BMX people. Griffin now into second. Hayes back into the fourth. Davis a solid third. As they turn it towards the scores, it looks like Adelot's got this one for color control. Darwin Griffin's brother Dana in for second. Davis and Bubba Hayes, the SC rider, making it for fourth.
Coming up now, the 15-year-old expert main event, Willie Nelson on the line, Robert Swick, BJ, Awesome, Bernard Gant, Elvis Joe Spurrier, Parnell Haley, Flying Brian Lopes, Todd Lyons, and Shan the Man Hatfield. The Awesome 15-year-old experts, the Wish I Had My Driver's License classes, down and off. Down the straightaway they go, it looks like Lopes and Lyons side by side, up and over the jump. Awesome, Bernard Gant goes to the inside and takes the lead away. It's Gant now with Lopes and Nelson going at it for second. BJ Gant from Tampa, Florida, the Eagle Snacks rider in front. He rails the second turn. Lopes now holding on to second, and look at Hatfield. Stuffing it in there, battling with the rest of the pack. It is Gant in front of Lopes with Hatfield, a Robinson rider in third. As they round the turn, it looks like BJ's got this one. A Vision Streetwear World Cup going to Awesome Bernard Gant. Brian Lopes going to take second. Hatfield coming across for third.
These top competitors are riding the huge wave of BMX excitement that's spreading around the world. Of course, on every wave, there's bound to be a few personal, wipeouts. once said that if you're not falling, you're not learning. Now onward to a group of guys who have done their fair share of learning, the Man of the Pro Cruiser main event.
The Pro Main on the big bikes happening now. The gate is down, and they're off down the straightaway. Looks like Palmer and Justice, Jared Justice on the inside. JJ, the Wheelworks Pro out of Pennsylvania, around in the turn. He's got Eric Roop on a Mongoose in second. It's Justice and Roop going at it now. And look at Eric Roop, the daddy from San Diego, California, railing the turn. Justice goes down, takes a whole pile with him. Palmer moving up in there. It's going to be Roop and Rick Palmer, the Skyway Pro, into second now. Out of the turn, it's going to be Roop and Palmer and the cowboy, Todd Slavik, as they head towards the finish line stripe. Eric, the daddy Roop, taking the win. Palmer and Slavik side by side, too close to call.
Hang on tight for training tip number 4 with flying Brian Lopes demonstrating his jumping techniques. Let's start with a typical step-up jump. We'll notice in a slow-motion review that Brian recoils his body and lifts the tail end of the bike up and over the final hump. Next up is Irvine's own monstrous canyon jump, a set of doubles. We'll notice again in slow motion, Brian recoils his body on takeoff of the first jump, landing on the backside of the second jump. Then comes speed jumping. You'll notice Brian will lift up and over with his front wheel, keeping the rear wheel on the ground, pedaling the whole time. The excitement's building. The 17 Expert main event up on the line with Mike Kenioklis, Mike King, Eric Carter, Billy Au, Danny Milwee, Lonnie Tatton, Glenn Pavlosky, and James Dean for Eagle Snacks. Look for hole shot artists King and Milwee. It's Milwee on the inside, King on the outside. They're battling and heading for the big doubles. Up and over, and there's Kenioklis and Pavlosky battling for that third spot. It's still King, our leader for Team Haro, out there stretching out the lead. Milwee in second spot, heading into the second turn. We've got Pavlosky making a dive. Also, James Dean in there for Team Hardy. It's King stretching it out still even further over Milwee, Pavlosky, Carter, and our Eagle Snacks rider. It's sure enough, it's going to be King. An easy win for him in the 17-over expert. Milwee in second and a hard charging. Eric Carter pulls off the third over Pavlosky. And Billy Au for Eagle Snacks in there for fifth. The top amateurs in the world here at the 17 Expert main event, the potential pros of the future.
On the gate now, the 18 Expert main event, the big amateurs. These guys, there's nowhere else to go after this. It's pro class or go home. On the gate, Mike Savage, Darwin Griffin, part of the Terrible 10. Todd Corbett, another Terrible 10. Jamison Hennert, looks like the best in BMX are definitely up here. Ronnie Walker, Terry Tenet, Cecil Johns, and Jeff Dinell. The Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX has brought them from all corners. Of course, Corbett and Walker are from Florida. Johns and Tenet are from Northern California. Griffin from Southern California, Mike Savage in the Northeast rider out of Connecticut, and we've got BMX, and it's Handler with a good start. Wow, Griffin on his outside, Jamison, the big boy. Watch Corbett, the Zellwood local. TC Todd, Corbett team Zellwood in front, and stretching it out. Oh, Charlie's got to be liking this one on her TV. It's Corbett and Handler with Tenet. Of course, Tenet took Corbett out yesterday. Watch TC in front, the Murray narrowly rider. It's goodbye Tenet. Handler, a 10 bike length stretch between Corbett and Handler. Now Savage, Johns, and Savage battling for third. It's Corbett now, the Zellwood guy. Team Cool Dad, the E-Team, gonna take it. Corbett, Handler, Cecil Johns moving up into the third spot. 18-year-old expert will be seeing Corbett in the pro class next year, probably a main event at the World Cup.
Scott, let's go back and look at the critical point of this race. Watch Griffin and Handler there. They're out in front, but as they go over this jump, Corbett goes to the air and takes it smooth and takes the lead away. Todd Corbett, aggressive style on the inside, made him a champion in this moto.
As you might guess, BMX racing is coming on strong, but a variation on the BMX bike, the freestyle bike, is also gaining a wide following. Freestyle riding actually consists of two separate styles, flatland and ramp, with competition and complex maneuvers to rival any other youth sport, and a lot of just plain rad thrown in.
that.
It sure is. You know, they're still getting a lot of radical air out here, too. Let's get back to the BMX action.
Okay. We got the A-Pro main event number one. They run a three main event format. The low points after the three rounds will determine the winner. I believe they're running for the $30,000 Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX. It'll be Malin Abrams, Todd Blazer, Gary Ellis, Pistol Pete Lunkarevich, Greg Lanthorne, Colonel Henry Nelson, Shannon, and Greg Hill.
$12,500 on the line for this particular division of pros, and Pistol Pete Lunkarevich gets a whole shot, and it's Greg Hill in the hot second spot. That's the two we chose to be battling in the main event.
Shannon now out of nowhere up into the third spot. It's Hill chasing Lunkarevich. Pistol Pete into the second turn with a three main event format. It could go either way down towards the finish line. It's going to be Lunkarevich, Hill, Shannon, Ellis, Blazer, Lanthorne trying to move up into the sixth spot. As they come out of the turn, Pistol Pete Lunkarevich setting himself up in the safe zone. Greg Hill, a strong second. Shannon Ellis, hot racing in the Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX main event number one for the A-Pros. Main event number one, it'll be Mike Moore, David Clymer, Jared Justice, Sean Newberry, Dana Griffin, Doug Davis, Bubba Hayes, and Kevin Adelot. We are talking next year's A-Pro main event in the B-Pro classes.
You got it, absolutely. And they'll be running the same format, Lenny. Three main events, low points, top winners.
It's looking good. You know, Jared Justice has been quietly just staying in the top parts of the pack. Dana Griffin, Doug Davis, he had a tough semi last time. We'll be looking for him to take the pressure off himself. Mike Moore, and the Space Commander, David Clymer.
In fact, before the first B-Pro main takes off, let's go to a pre-recorded interview with the colorful Mr. Clymer.
Dave, tell us about your lifestyle.
Work and ride. Work all day and then ride until I can't see no more in the night.
Well, it looks like at night you're kind of an adventurous person. Tell us about the hair.
Well, at my house, it's like the style and like everybody's into it there. New wave.
What is your style? I see this on your helmet. What is that?
66 Sputnik, it's a punk rock group.
What else are some of the groups you listen to?
Love and Rockets, Dead Milkman. Anything like new wave or hardcore.
So that's your choice in music?
Yeah.
What about lifestyle? Hardcore all the way?
Yeah, racing hardcore.
Love that David Clymer.
Gate goes down.
What a snap by Dana Griffin. He's got the whole shot, absolutely. Doug Davis, Clymer, and Justice on the outside.
Wow.
Davis is still uncomfortable with that double jump. Bubba Hayes giving Davis a little bump.
Clymer into the second spot. It's Dana Griffin with about a 5-bike-length lead. Dave Clymer, Bubba Hayes into the third spot with Mike Moore. As they charge around the track, Dana Griffin, Clymer pedaling in the air, working hard, trying to stay in second. He's got Hayes on him like a dirty
Griffin
shirt.
Griffin has some horsepower. Look at him pull down those straightaways. And here's Clymer yanking on it, pulling those bars to go. Bubba Hayes tired a little in that last straightaway.
Looks like Moore got him at the finish line.
He sure did. Moore got the third place. Bubba Hayes is going to have to drop to fourth.
Round number one complete for A and B Pros. They'll be back up soon.
Phenomenal action. Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX on ESPN.
As we look to the line now, it's A-Pro main event number two. Of course, the first time it was Pistol Pete Lunkarevich taking the win, Greg Hill, and then Nelson Shannon. We'll be watching this time, see where the riders move and swap positions and who comes out on top. Getting ready for A-Pro main event number three. It's number two on the line now, ready to go. The gate's about to drop. We're watching. We're ready. We're looking at Malin Abrams, Todd Blazer. The gate is down. They're off and going. It looks like Ellis and Hill with Lunkarevich on the outside as they come up and down the first jump. It looks like Pistol Pete's got the lead again. It's Lunkarevich and Greg Hill with Gary Ellis, the lumberjack from Washington. And front, Pistol Pete holding him off. The Haro product rider out of El Toro, California. Lunkarevich, Greg Hill still right there on him. Hill trying to find a way around him, kind of conservative into that back turn. It looks like Lunkarevich, Hill, no time to play conservative, trying to gas it down the back straightaway. It's going to be Pistol Pete 1, Greg Hill the 2nd, Ellis and Todd Blazer for 4th. a lot can be said about the pro class. It's a little rough, a little crazy, and Greg Hill is the ultimate professional. Now watch here as the pro mind works in Greg Hill. He doesn't take advantage of a move, but he takes advantage of staying up. Instead of going to the inside and taking Lunkarevich out, he backs away, plays it conservative, and then comes up with a solid second rather than chance of crashing with Lunkarevich and maybe taking himself out of the money.
Of course, Lenny, we know the guys relate well to the macho and the muscling of the pro mains, but what about the girls? What's their perspective on the sport?
How long have you been racing?
4 years.
4 years. You've won some pretty impressive trophies, huh?
Yeah.
Well, if you were looking out there and you were going to talk to some of the girls around the country, what would you say to them to get them out to the BMX track?
Well, it's sort of fun, and you would enjoy it, and it's fun.
The boys treat you okay out here?
Yeah.
Not a lot of problems with them?
No.
Have you ever raced the boys? Have you beat them?
Yeah, a lot of times.
We've got one of the Irvine BMX parents here, Pam Hernandez. Pam, tell us what it's like being a BMX mom.
Well, it's a lot of hard work. It's getting up bright and early in the morning, being out in the dust all day, meeting a lot of real nice people.
I'm here with top BMX girl, Bonnie Hutland of the Hardee's National Foods BMX team. Bonnie, tell us something about your BMX career.
Well, I've been racing for 12 years, and I've traveled all over the country. I'm still loving it. Just the friends are the greatest, the competition. You love it, you can't get out of it.
What do you think about BMX guys?
I think they're gorgeous. It's like, yeah.
Yeah, about 25 girls out here and 1,000 guys. It's great.
I've met a lot of fun people. A lot of professionals are here. A lot of nice gentlemen. They're very sweet. And they're a lot of fun to be around.
That's my girlfriend. Most guys have companies who sponsor them. She sponsored me. She's Kathy. She's really cool.
She behind you?
All the way.
On the line now, B-Pro round number 2, Davis, Griffin, Justice, and of course the Space Commander, Dave Clymer. Darwin Griffin's brother, Dana, taking the first one. Clymer the second, and the gate goes down. Clymer having his trouble out of the gate. Out in front now, it's the Texas Pro, Mike Moore. Dallas, Texas in front, and look at Dana Griffin. Out in front again, Dougie Davis, the San Diego Pro, going to the inside, caused a little havoc in the first turn. Looked like a couple of the pros went down, and Clymer moves up to fifth. In front, though, Diamondback, silver streaking it. It's Doug Davis. Dana Griffin, the Boss Pro, in second. As they round the turn, looks like J.J. Jared Justice is back there in third. Griffin chasing Davis down the back straightaway. It's going to be Doug Reggie Davis coming across the line, taking a win. Griffin Justice, your top three.
Training tip number 5, Brian Lopes with some hot and heavy action, cornering and block passing. Okay, in our cornering, we have Brian Lopes showing you the rail method. That is the fastest possible way through a hairpin-type turn. Notice he'll set up on the outside, trying to keep up his full momentum and speed as he exits the corner. Let's take the same turn and consider block passing. This is where Brian would have an opponent on his outside, so he swings to the inside, grabs his brakes, then proceeds to the top of the turn, blocking the other rider by squaring off the turn, thus leaving the other rider without any momentum, and Brian in the lead. Welcome back to the Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX. We've got the final two mains, the A and B Pros, getting ready to battle it out for the big bucks. $30,000 this time, Lenny. Who's our lead man?
Pistol Pete Lunkarevich sits in the hot seat. He's got 2 wins, 2 points. Low points is going to take it. Pete's got all the pressure on him.
But Greg Hill with 4 points is right on his tail. Pete makes a slip up. Hill's right in there.
Gary Ellis, the lumberjack from Washington, in third with 7 points.
Okay, then comes the blazing Todd Blazer with 9 points, who might have a real slight outside chance if a couple go down.
Gates down, this is it, and Lunkarevich in the middle with Blazer right on it.
Inside.
Oh, watch Blazer jamming on the inside. He looks like it says it's Abrams now in a second. It's Lunkarevich, Abrams, Blazer. There's Hill battling with Shannity in the fourth spot. Greg's having his troubles. It's Lunkarevich in front. Whoa, Pistol Pete's out of it. Oh, man, this is going to be tight.
Abrams in front. Blazer Lunkarevich going, setting his sights as they come down the back straightaway. Malin Abrams, former World Cup winner in the amateur classes, jamming towards the finish line as a pro. It's Abrams and Blazer.
Lunkarevich, Hill. Oh. I didn't see who was on the outside. That mixes up some points. I think Blazer just moved himself into third spot. Pete's going to hold down the first, of course. Abrams had 12 points coming into this race, Lenny, so he's going to end up with 13 now, which will bring him all the way up to about fifth.
Let's go back and look at a truly professional move, the setup pass. Abrams in third, now in a second. He stays to the left side of the track. As Lunkarevich looks over his right shoulder, Abrams even goes farther outside, goes high, and then cuts in low early, taking the lead away from Pistol Pete Lunkarevich.
Locked and loaded. They're ready to go. And they're off like a dirty shirt in this one. Dana Griffin right out and charging. Whoa, boy, he's got Space
Climber
Commander Climber on the inside. Griffin, Climber, now
Climber
taking
takes the lead.
Oh, you got to take this one. Davey Climber in front, the Lansdale PA guy, red
and
hair.
Dana Griffin drops all the way back to seventh
oh,
spot.
Man, this
could be the upset. Look at all the riders, look out. We've
Climber. A 10-bike length lead or more for David Climber, the Space Commander. He's looking over here at the announcing booth, waving to us as he comes down. Adelot on the side of him. Bubba Hayes back there in fourth. Newberry, it's going to be a win for Climber taking it. This guy, he must be talking to that spaceship up there somewhere. Climber, your winner,
boy,
taking the final meet
in all our finals. This is amazing. I have with me Dana Griffiths. He was leading after the second moto coming into the B Pro final. Tension had to have been hot and heavy, the biggest pro purse you've ever ridden for. Tell us what happened in the main.
I got a pretty good start and went over the first doubles leading, and David just swooped me. And then they had to pile up in the second corner.
Did you get caught up in the pile up?
Yes, I did.
It's unfortunate it dropped you back to second place, but that's not too shabby in the big bucks that are going out today at the Vision Streetwear World Cup.
Yeah, I'm happy with it.
Fantastic. No sore loser here.
No, not right now.
Great. Congratulations, Dana, and thank you.
Just caught up with Dave Climber. You just won the B-Pro main event round number three. You're the overall winner, Dave.
Like dreamland right now. I can't believe it.
Oh, man, how did it feel out there?
Great. I was, like, so nervous. Then I got the good clean move in the first turn. I'm like, oh, my God, I don't believe it.
So you're jazzing, huh?
Definitely.
Congratulations, Dave Climber, winner of the B-Pro at the Vision World Cup of BMX. Congratulations, our team. The orange hair looking good.
For our sixth and final training tip with Flying Brian Lopes, let's take a look at the finish line sprint. Remember to speed jump every obstacle in front of you. Don't look over your shoulder. Keep your head straight and forward for the finish line victory.
If you use these racing tips regularly, you could be a winner too.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've just finished off the Big Buck Pro Class, the A Pro Class, here at the Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX. Our winner today, Pistol Pete Lunkarevich, national number one, ABA, NBL, and USBA in 1986. He's back to attack again. How'd you like it?
I love it. And that, if it wasn't for all my hard training, all my support from everybody, my mom and dad, and all my sponsors, I wouldn't be here today. And I'd like to thank everybody out there that was supporting me. And I'll see you next year in the winner's circle.
You got that right. My name's Scott Brightup, your host today, along with Lenny Batikian. We'd like to thank Linda Dorsey, of course, our interviewer. And we'll be back next year for the Vision Streetwear World Cup of BMX.
See you then.